This fourth Sunday of Advent makes us continue in the joy of the latest Sunday as we draw closer to the birthday of our Lord. All these 4 weeks we have been praying for the coming of the Lord, and our opening hymn was exactly in that vein. Come, come, we still need you. This was the theme for our first Sunday of Advent. The second Sunday, God told us that clear the way and I shall come. And last Sunday, we saw that everything was working well to our best advantage. And if God has done his part, we also need to do our part. And today the Word of God invites us to take some time and do something for God in return, because the generosity of our heart will be rewarded for generations. This is the message Nathan gave to David. He told him that go and do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you. This was after David had suggested to Nathan the idea of building a temple for the Lord. This was a generous wish from David, wanting to do something for God, who had seen him through all his days since the time he was anointed by prophet Samuel. He drew him from being a shepherd of sheep and made him a leader of his people. He acknowledged that it was the hand of God and his generous support and care that made him rise from being a shepherd of sheep to the great king he became. And as king, God continued to work with him, to fight his enemies, to bring protection to the people he was leading, to build a powerful city, and who was now in a big palace. After all this, he turned his heart to God and said, I should make you a house in gratitude. His generosity of heart was supported by Prophet Nathan. But later during the night, the prophet was given another message to adjust a little in the plan David had. And God suggested that it would not be David to build him a house. Instead, the one who would succeed him would build him a house. To this, David consented. In his mind, and I think in the mind of Prophet Nathan, their idea was about a physical and material building. And when God says, I myself will instead build you a stable, solid, and everlasting house, he was referring to something bigger. He was meaning the family of David to remain a strong house in the leadership of Israel. And out of this strong leadership, God would pick someone to lead yet another bigger house, this time an everlasting house, which is the church we are in today. So you see, God begins with small things and supplies abundance. Abundance that is everlasting. So he's inviting us in time today, as we draw closer to Christmas, to open our hearts generously to him, to think of something can do for him generously so that from there he can build another wave of generosity that will last for generations, that will spread to all people, that will make our names make a legacy like David left, and his name is being attached to the Son of God, who is being pronounced to Mary in a special way today as the ancestor of the Son of God. This big house that the Lord put in place, as I have said, came from a humble stock within the dynasty of David. We know very well the history of Israel. After David, his family reigned over Israel for 400 years. And when the Babylonian exile came, the last king in his line was King Zedekiah. He was taken to Babylon and killed there with his family. This appeared to be the closure of the dynasty of David. But God, in a wonderful way, chose a humble lady in a very humble town of Nazareth, of whom we have heard today. From that humble lady, he rebuilt the dynasty of David. And today the angel comes to her to tell her that you are highly favored, so highly favored. And she listened to the message, head full of grace. Those are powerful words. And they made her wonder what a greeting that might have been. Step by step, the angel led her to understand that she was being chosen to be the mother of the Son of God Most High. And to this Son is attached the promises God had given to David in the first reading we have heard. This child will be a strong personality. He would sit on the throne of David, his ancestor. He would rule the house of David forever, and his kingdom will last forever. God would not have referred to the kingdom of David if that kingdom never existed. He had it in mind, and the hopes people preserved in their hearts are now being revealed. From David's humble wish to generously build a temple for the Lord, we now have God coming up with a generous plan, which is even extravagant, promising an everlasting kingdom through the line of David, beginning in the humble man, who in turn made a generous yes to God. She made a generous yes, and when she generously said yes to God, the world was given a Savior, the everlasting Lord of life, the everlasting Lord of peace, the everlasting Lord of joy. And this is the joy we shall be celebrating on Christmas Day. Her humble yes and openness of heart to God brought forth this eternal favor upon humanity. This is the generous heart that God would like us to learn from David, who made a generous wish, and learn from Mary, who made a generous yes to God, and humanity was blessed for generations. And this is the blessing we still enjoy in the church today, as St. Paul has wondered at the mysterious ways in which God works, the ways in which God reveals his plans of salvation through the writings of prophets, through revelations he made, like the revelation he made to David and the revelation he made to Mary, and in the ways God strengthens his people through all generations. He never tires to join with his people. He never tires to come to us and he never tires to act and have all things happen in our favor. And this is the God we are embracing on Christmas Day, who is calling upon each one of us to take some time this week before the birthday of the Lord to do something with a generous heart, so that from there he can begin building a chain of blessings that will last for generations. May God help us to answer this invitation generously. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.